Φίλες και φίλοι, καλησπέρα. Είμαι ο Πάνος και σας καλωσορίζω στο επόμενο μέρος του Alice Madness Returns, No Commentary Walkthrough. Την προηγούμενη φορά είχαμε τελειώσει το πρώτο chapter, το οποίο λεγόταν Hatter's Domain. Οπότε πάμε να δούμε τι μας επιφυλάσσει το chapter 2, το οποίο λέγεται Diluted Depths. Καλή θέαση.
Caught my very own ribbon then.
Saints be praised that he works in mysterious ways. You got plans for her?
Take her over to the Mangled Mermaid. Rent a bed.
Hard to woo a girl, Mr. Broughton.
Do you think you're doing?
What comes natural, like?
Not natural to me. Get away. The white cat reminds me of my Snowdrop. Nanny knew her.
Where's me money, you fucking spunk bucket?
Get those fat-assed whores out on the street, or I'll come up and brain
you. Shut off, you cocker snipe. You'll never get past Long Tim.
I'll get what you and your floozies owe me, Miss Ladybird. See if I don't.
Maybe you notice I'm not pissing me drawers at the prospect. Alice Little, you'll make a nice change. Bring your disheveled self up here.
You won't give me what I want? I'll burn this dump of yours down to the ground.
Go away. She's done no harm.
She hurt me feelings.
Act like a snuffed candle. Sleep, sleep.
Thank you. Lost. She was not built for navigating the Arctic ice fields. The recent competition of governments in fitting out polar expeditions is a needless waste of human life.
Thank you.
Pris Witless never saw a bottle of gin she couldn't empty in an hour. Do most anything for threepence and the long taste of blue beer.
Alice, I know your fondness for all manner of puzzles. How is the Queen of Hearts like a typhoon? Wrong, wrong, and wrong. What is yours, but others use it more than you do? You're correct, miss. Thank you.
Better come aboard, Alice.
We're doomed, of course.
What? There's no hope then.
Oh, there's an infinite amount of hope, but not for us. Now get up here. Confounded beasts. They want my ship.
I think you're more to their taste.
Never. We're almost relatives.
You're related to Sue, Admiral.
I've an idea. We'll leave this mayhem and go to Carpenter's show. It's better than gaff. Carpenter promises what we don't take seriously can't harm us.
Best dive now, Admiral, or the sharks will have us for lunch. All over. We submerged too quickly.
My ship's a wreck, and I am too.
Admirals go down with their ships. In any case, I never knew you for a sailor. If memory serves, you were station master of the Looking Glass line.
Sacked from the railroad, without the option. Redundant, the nitwit said. Never a holiday. Loyal as a bulldog. Going in a different direction, my Aunt Fanny, if I had one. Going off the rails more like. Bloody disaster. Now I'm shipless. The old railroad's dead. And this new thing's a monstrosity. It never runs on time. Engineers asleep at the switch. What I don't know about it can't hurt me. Say no more. Nod's as good as a wink. Change the subject. We avoid speaking about the thing whose name should not be spoken.
Hearing something useful about this new train would make for a change.
You don't respect the suffering of others. Go ask your questions and smart remarks to Caterpillar.
I'm sorry, Admiral, really. Please, tell me what you know about the train.
I'll just say we've escaped a contaminating corruption. Count yourself lucky to be down here.
But I don't want to escape. I want to stop it. I must stop it to save myself. And Wonderland, too.
Nonsense. Speak more nonsense. Diversions rule the day. The show must go on and so on. Speaking of shows...
We weren't.
Yeah, well, never mind. Here's a ticket for the show Carpenter's mounting. Use it.
Scoundrels fitted with grotesque headgear. If I have ever owned an accessory that unseemly, I'd burn it. Destroy all evidence of it and deny its existence. I value my reputation.
I was the last one in the library the night of the fire. The log I added to the grate was dead when I went upstairs to bed with Dinah. If it wasn't, I may be responsible for my family's deaths.
Thank you.
what lies beneath this patina of civility. Something wicked, I'll wager.
Dermis was singed to the third layer, and the rest of her skin was as brittle as carp scales.
Yes. Delighted to see you again, my dear. Your arrival is filled with fortunatality itself.
Really? I didn't even know...
Never mind. My pregnant show is about to pop. It requires only a medicament of your help, Velocity.
I don't have much experience, but I do need to reconstruct my...
Wickenbarter, have a nice screwdriver, nearly new, or a nice hammer if you're...
There's a train that's corrupting Wonderland, and I'm looking for help to restrain or destroy it.
Most vexatious, no doubt, will address that monstrosity directly. That's to say, eventually. Now, let's intermediate more important matters. Due to a large hysterical foul-up, some of the show's requisites need to be gathered. The munificent script needs fetching. The writer's overly imaginative and exploring several endings. Then you'll need to assemble the show's tune-deft music. And finally, gather our stars! The show's tasteful performers.
You should leave now.
The essentiality of haste is essential.
It hardly seems you're ready for the show. Why can't you assemble these things yourself?
An impresario has arrangements. Ducks in a row, fish to fry, calls to Newcastle, etc., etc. Fetch the script from the writer, then we can batter or clatter or natter, as the case may be.
Is the writer cantankerous?
To a personage of your distinguished repudiation? I blush at the notionality. He's an octopus, by the by. Lives over that way. Ta-ta.
You're sufficiently fortified to kick some to boot these creatures' nether regions.
Much time practicing as you do in Wonderland, you'd be the next Sullivan or Gilbert, or one of them.
place smells like a ripe distillery with a whiff of halitosis and urine.
That's a scent of unrecognized genius. So piss off.
More empties than a Dublin brewery. The carpenter sent me.
For starters, the carpenter is a pusillanimous, parsimonious, pettifogging moron.
That's his maybe, but he sent me for this script. I need...
Your need's a shite. I need a drink. Who cares? I need those responsible for my abortive career in chains. No joy. I need to know what love is. The world is mum. Just now, I need a dose of hide and seek. Find me thrice, fair maid. Be quick about it, and we can deal.
A lifetime hiding his true colors gives him an edge, but he can't conceal the way he moves.
This is too easy! have me now, you won't have me again.
Unpleasantness, remote in time and space, has only as much power as vivid memory of it.
It's all in the game. A fair cop. You've won. You're a good sport. And no one died. Join me in the library. Unlike some, I don't Welsh. The carpenter commissioned a solemn dance number on morality. Art and good sense be damned. He demands mirth, silliness, and a strained debauchery all round. Morris will do a hero turn as death. Imagine! I'll bring the script to the theatre. You can be on your way. No doubt Carmen has got you collecting piscine divas for the musical portion. The man really hires a proper talent. Some fish can sing, but no more.
I'm not terribly musical, but you seem out of tune.
It's not my fault. I can't hear my notes. The pipes are obstructed.
I can see that. Why not do something about it?
And endanger my vocal cords. You might do it for
Everyone
me.
Everyone here has an excuse for doing nothing. Reminds me of the asylum.
You've made a respectable start to it, but a decent job would require considerably more application. I'm sure you'd like to do a decent job.
Thank you.
that's all well and good. But my range needs a fully functional orchestra. There's something wrong. I can't find the time for the notes.
It's surely not lost. Perhaps mislaid. I suppose I'll have to help you carry the tune. Better be light. I doubt it.
The performer's meager efforts will be enhanced by my musical score. Please wake them with this exciting news.
It was the smoke, you see. One day, you'll be joining them in the Oxford family vault, I imagine.
Two down, one to go. Oysters are the presumptive stars of the show, if you can wake them.
You just interrupted my dreams. Oh well. Off to the show, I suppose. For the show. It's ruined. If I can't put it back together, Carpenter will grind my pearls.
The proper order of things is often a mystery to me. You too.
I need the poster now. before the show begins. Back together. Could be here any minute. How does this work? Where do these pieces go? Let us resume our place before our adoring fans at the theater.
Impresario, you're a killer. The mastermind of a criminal enterprise.
This world is not so either or, Alice.
And I've done your bidding.
You did a few errands, got your hands dirty. Big deal. The show distraculates the crowd. Shame you'll miss it. You need to deal with these sailors. It's your time.
Time? Time? The time has come to talk of ships and vegetables and royalty and
and where the pigs have wings and so on.
Enough of that, Walrus. You start willing about there being too much sand on the beach, I'll have your blubber for breakfast.
Shame on you, Carpenter. You made a promise.
I had no choice. One can't always do as one would like. I'd have thought you'd know that by now.
Pets are friends in our secret cells, Alice. Your rabbit, too. I'm sure Dinah was a confidant. Always about, wasn't she?
Hostile at first, but their true souls are trapped. You must release them.
Do they want to be at peace?
They do not know their own minds. What's true of the living is often true of the dead.
Thank you.
a savior of a sort. Soul be so ignorant. I'm an answered prayer.
Thank you.
along, Alice.
Trouble?
Thank you.
as good to yourself as you've been to us. Haul anchor and heave to, men. It's the wide and glorious main for us.
There's no time to waste. There's no time at all.
Thank you.
Come, Alice, don't dawdle. You've already missed the train.
Every picture tells a story. Sometimes we don't like the ending. Sometimes we don't understand it.
Gentlemen, welcome to the show!
What a bizarre show.
That's quite enough of that, I think. Enough preliminaries. Here's the performance you've been waiting for. Proves I'm without prejudice and have a fine sense of humour. Sword and crown are worthless here. I invite everyone to dance. Labourers, lawyers, church and gown all make their little prance. This life is full of random deaths and heaps of grief and shame. So few are soothed by accident. You want someone to blame. Fire, plague, and strange disease. Drowned, murdered, or if you please. A long fall down the basement stairs. None are expected. No one cares. I often must work very hard, sweat running down my skin. After the dance, I then must rest, and the eating can begin. Time to eat. Death is the ultimate equalizer. All have the right to be eaten.
Get in line, Princess. Don't push. All will be served.
So to speak.
Wicked thing. Feasting while Wonderland is destroyed.
I'm not the enemy you seek, Alice. I tried to hide this bit of Wonderland from that beast. Appeasement's never clean. We must all play our assigned roles. Are you a pawn or a queen? An idiot or a practiced fool? However this turns out, consider the prospect that you've been misled, Alice. Then ask, by whom?
No! Who set that bloody train in motion? Where has it come from?
It arrived when you arrived, and it's more horrible even than you can currently imagine. The death of a dream! Caterpillar may know how!
What? The blood in my mouth tastes like bile.
Where's the brute that hit me, Nanny?
Nasty Pratt's out cold. Not dead, and more's the pity.
What did he want?
What they all want. Money he didn't earn. What were you thinking, butting into that mess? You could have been killed.
Nanny, my mind's in pieces. I still have terrible visions, and I need to know.
About the fire. Same as always. You need to move on, Alice. So do I.
Well, at least she's not spewing that asylum nonsense.
My past is dead. I killed them. I should have saved them. I should have died. Her mind was in shambles. Radcliffe thought familiar faces would bring her round. After a year, he lost interest in her inheritance. Greedy sod. Still, always asking his bizarre questions. Heavy dose of madness, I'd say, but honesty is never the best policy in this life. When she wasn't comatose, she gaped, eyes like pinwheels, drooled, occasionally screeched. Never uttered a sensible sound. And like the child she was, she kept her secrets close.
Gone off some lurkers, common as cockroaches. And those poor tykes are food for perverts, like the blameless ants that wasps consume or spiders' feeble prey. You visited my room at Rutledge. What were you...
You recall that? Radcliffe paid me for a bit. A woman alone sometimes does what she doesn't particularly feel like doing. As you know.
Nurse Whitler said you'd fallen on hard times.
I'm no drunk like her. I'm hurting no one. Hooking's not a bad life.
Except for the pimps. She also said you might have my rabbit. Please, Nanny, talk about
the damn fire. Never seems to help. Look, Alice, I can't give you what I don't have. Radcliffe wrote the inquest report. I'll take you to him. Besides, he's got your damn rabbit. You should remember that.
All right, but Mr. Radcliffe's useless.
Don't I know it.
Εδώ λοιπόν τελειώνει και αυτό το μοναδικό chapter, οπότε μείνετε μαζί μου και για την συνέχεια, κατά την οποία θα ξεδιπλώσουμε μαζί τον σκοτεινό και σχιζοφρενικό κόσμο, ο οποίος κρύβεται βαθιά μέσα στο μυαλό της Alice Little. Καλή συνέχεια!